So you're making some noise out here, Joe.
We're making a little noise because more and more people are talking about torture. Nancy Pelosi is running from one side of Washington, D.C. to the other. She has now called the CIA liars, which means the CIA will drip, 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 get the stuff out to the public. And we'll find out exactly how much she knew. A couple of years ago, we told Blumenauer.
I remember.
When Pelosi was here in Portland, we tried to get to the press conference to ask her this question. Why are you stopping impeachment, and how much did you know about the torture? They threw up a human block of staffers to keep us from that press conference 2 years ago. Now the mainstream media is finally catching on that Pelosi and Hoyer and Emanuel and Reed and Rockefeller, all Democrats, knew what was going on. Did nothing. And I think Jane Harman, she was involved in that.
Who, Jane Harman?
Jane Harman.
Who's she, Joe?
At one time, she was the highest ranking Democrat on the Intelligence Committee. She wrote a letter protesting to the CIA. So if she can write a letter to protest the CIA, what Nancy Pelosi is saying today that she couldn't say anything, couldn't object to anything, is a straight out lie. Straight out. She's lying. The CIA may be lying too. They're not my favorite people. However, Nancy Pelosi is a liar, and she should go with the rest of them. She's corrupted. Just like this judge. That's why we're here in the Ninth Circuit Court of Appeals, because if you take a sniff, it doesn't smell so good in the Court of Appeals. Can you smell that? Oh, it's awful.
I can smell it.
It's awful.
Yeah.
Oh. We have a torturer on the Court of Appeals. He's running around trying to get the Congress people to support him. But Obama held a town meeting today about credit cards. That was the topic of the day. Do you know what the reporters are asking everybody?
Hmm.
How much did you know about torture?
Yeah, he wants to talk about credit cards.
That's
not
right.
That that's a big crooked business anyway, but come
it's
on.
Very crooked, very corrupt. However.
However.
They murdered people. Don't talk about hitting someone's head against the wall or slapping them in the face. How about mass murder? We know 25 could be in the hundreds. In our custody, beaten to death, failed waterboarding, did it wrong, they died, head against the wall, arms above their heads, they suffocated, they died, they were beaten and kicked to death. But we don't want to look back at that. We want to go forward, must go forward.
What about these torture pictures that Obama's now suppressing? How do you feel about that?
Yeah.
The pictures are already getting out?
Yeah, they're beginning to be leaked.
I knew
they
would be.
They're coming out anyway.
Mm-hmm.
However, for Obama to take the position that these pictures are going to hurt the image of the United States of America internationally is laughable. Give me a break. We have no reputation. You have to get it back. And the only way to get it back is to sit down with friendly Arab countries like Jordan and say, hey guys, we're going to release these pictures. Can you help us? Can you support it? Saying that it's a good thing that we do that. That's what it takes. We have to go to the Arab countries and say, we were wrong.
Yeah.
Now it's a new game in town.
Joe, it seems like to me it's almost like it's the uncle. Let's use Uncle Sam just for a name.
Okay.
The uncle's been doing something wrong to the family, and now the family's hiding everything because it's going to embarrass the uncle, it's going to make them look bad and such like that, so they want to suppress it. Don't let the news get out about what the uncle did.
I think it's more complicated than that. I think that's a really good point. We got this crazy uncle called Bush or Cheney that are running around, and we don't really want to bring that to Thanksgiving dinner because they embarrass us. However, they've done some really terrible things. And I think the hesitation is Pelosi and the other leadership are terrified that they're going to get dragged into this. That's all the reasons that she gave and Blumenauer gave and Wyden gave made no sense to any of us that had an IQ over 25. Didn't make any sense. Well, we don't want the circus and we don't want to do this and we don't want to bring up, well, we want to go forward. None of that makes any sense. What does make sense is Nancy Pelosi is corrupt. Reed is corrupt. Hoyer is corrupt. Emanuel, who is now the staff guy of the President of the United States, is corrupt. And I don't say they misled us, I say they're liars. Liars.
It's also seemingly that Cheney, who we didn't see much of, he's just out and about every other day trying to defend himself. I think he's worried and protecting himself as well as this stuff all surfaces.
Cheney's taking an interesting position. He's saying we didn't torture because the lawyers told us this level of intensity is not torture. This other level is. So we always stayed at this level. Now, if you torture someone and they died, which level are you on? Are you on the Cheney level? Or are you below that? You killed the guy. You murdered him. That's what Cheney is trying to defend. And if people listen to this guy now, people are just so gold. If he keeps saying it, some people will believe him. And since he's running about 13% approval rating, I don't think he can get any lower because we have probably 20% of the population are all lunatics. And he's at 13, so he doesn't even have the lunatic fringe.
I'm going to get your poster here and then ask you something about what you're holding.
Okay.
Let's see, a little waterboarding there. Thank you.
We are all better.